Let's start. It is 5 minutes past seven. So, okay, you know, few slides, and you know, for the benefit of, as I understand, the majority of the audience is 34th batch students across our you know, four branches. Majority of these things are known because last 1.5 year in college at IIP, and now you know, some of you have started summer training, but you know, in the midst of summer training, now you know, we are, all of us are sitting home, whether they are fresh students or, you know, experienced people. So majority of things which I'm going to share quickly are known to people. There are a few examples which I have picked up, and then, you know, at the end of it, I encourage, as I always say, the audience is always encouraged to ask questions. To the best of my ability, my knowledge, my experience, I will try to answer those. If I am not, as I say, I always park it. I will never try to give an answer where, you know, I'm not sure
created
about
with
it.
Free version for non-commercial.
So let's
use.
Get started. So, you know, packaging and packaging materials, I always say packaging, which we have studied, you know, is a science, art and technology. So it is a mix of all these things. There are very few fields in the world which has a mix of these three things, you know. So packaging is one. This everyone knows, packaging technology, but a quick screenshot, you know, why it is defined and what packaging means. It basically contains, protects, preserves, transports, informs, sells. Selling is very important part in every FMCG or every company where we work in the industry, because finally when the product is sold and the customer or the consumer, as we call, when the consumer is delighted to with the packaging first and then with the product itself, there is a repeat purchase. So, you know, very important role. Selling also involves brand recognition, innovation comes under it, and now, you know, sustainability, which we'll touch upon at the last. So till it is safely consumed, because that is what the main function of packaging is. Four basic packaging materials. All of us have studied, you know, we have the entire semester dedicated for these subjects. So whether it is, you know, wood and paper, wood is where the basic packaging started several centuries ago. Cellulose based materials, and then from there paper. So whether it is wooden boxes, pallets, what get used, and even today in heavy engineering for transportation, craft paper, paper board, corrugated fiber board boxes, or shipper, as we call. Metals, of course, were an important part. They are still an important part. Tin plate, aluminium, you know, foil and cans, because even though multi-layer laminates are there, but still, you know, aluminium foil, where high barrier is required, forms an important part. So glass, and even soaking bottles, plastics, as we call, you know, last 20, 30 years, plastics has been forming a very important part of everything and what we do. Basically, where we started, the industry started, the world started with plastics for its benefits. Majority of it was cost saving and yield while delivering, you know, shelf life. But today, with this, I have already discussed, but you know, just for the benefit of people who have joined just now, that you know, basic packaging things which I spoke about, materials which I was on. So, you know, wood, paper, as we said, you know, entire 5 months we have entire subjects on each of these packaging, four basic packaging materials. And then, you know, multi-layer laminates and composite materials and all. So this is what our packaging life is. This is what packaging is all about in the entire world. So what we study in our 2 years post-graduation, what in we will do in our career, but this is what is the entire world sees. So what we do, what we work, all these four packaging materials people interact. Many times there are several confusions about packaging in the world, but about the materials also, but we have studied each of these subjects. So next, this I am put, you know, packaging development per se, why I put this one or two slides is, as packaging development, we say, you know, packaging is of a product. So a good packaging development person always understands the product characteristics better. So I have seen in my entire working life, there are packaging development people, but you have to understand that there is a product which has to be packaged. So these two are like husband and wife, you know, both play 50-50 important part till it is delivered to the consumer. So product characteristics, few of those which I have listed, and one or two highlighted like active ingredients, stability, and desired shelf life. These play a very important role in what a packaging person does. And a good packaging development person
created
or a packaging person
is
one who understands the product characteristics from his counterpart in R&D. Because every product shelf life studies are done, product package testing is done. We are experts in packaging, but finally you have to understand that product is what the package has to deliver to the market, to the consumer. So when you understand in each of these companies where you will work, whether they are engineering companies, heavy engineering like L&T also, or whether you are working in FMCG, food products, pharma products, FMCG products companies, toothpaste, everything what you talk of. A good packaging person always understands what are the key characteristics of the product. Knowing those characteristics, you develop or design a packaging which passes the stability studies, desired shelf life studies, and delivers to the consumer. So always a good interaction between R&D and a packaging guy will always lead to lesser problems when we design packaging, when we develop new type of packaging, when shelf life studies are done. So I felt this is very important. And then of course the product package interaction, which I spoke, and package environment, because that is what it is. Finally, when the packs are made in the in the factories, they go out in the environment till they reach the consumer. So all type of environments it has to undergo. Environmental factors we know, but a quick list: air, where oxygen and other gases interact; light, which is sunlight, visible, and UV. Light, why I mentioned, visible and UV also. UV we cannot see, but UV definitely affects every organism on this planet. Water, of course, moisture, and microbes. Now the entire world is talking of microbes. So I was, microbes information also, in food products, in products which get spoiled by microbes. These microbes are similar to what we are seeing today or what we are experiencing with respect to your health. So there are good microbes, as we call
created
yeast,
with free
which is in,
for non-commercial
ghee
use.
Or yogurt, as we call. And then there are bad microbes. We know, what the entire world is experiencing today. So these environmental factors affect not only the package, every single thing. Aging stability studies, room temperature elevated, and protective containment is essential. Now, today also when we talk of COVID, finally we come back to the same basics in science or basics in microbiology or, specific fields. Containment. So containment, today all the human beings are under containment. It's locked in our houses, trying to protect ourselves and our families from this microbe. So positive seal and closures play an important part in packaging, because every package has an opening, and that opening generally is a weak point in any package. So closures may be caps, and those type of closures, they may be sealing also, inflexible, where you do a heat seal.
Created
but closure
with
plays a very important
use.
Part also in the packaging. Closure generally are the weak points also. Closures are the points where if the sealing or closing is not done properly, the above four, air, light, water, or microbes can enter and spoil the product. And then, of course, you require easy opening also. Closures, again, just quick one slide on that. They provide access. The oldest closure or historical was the cork stopper. And it provides protective containment through positive seal. Now, positive seal is what is very important. Positive seal, which doesn't allow, air, moisture, light, or microbes to enter. Tamper-evident, everyone knows. Continuous, these are just the type of closures. Again, tamper-evident closures, we all know. They communicate to the consumer if something has been tampered, opened, so that when, there are warnings to the consumer. Child-resistant, again, specific to small children. Very important in terms of pharma products, in terms of pesticides, in terms of dangerous things, where if the child gets access, we can have problems. So child resistant closures are there. There are standards in many countries where certain products have to pass the test of a child resistant closure. Aesthetic closures, special functions, closure materials. Again, when we come to materials, again, same thing, because whatever gets used for packaging also gets used for closures. So whether it is plastic, metal, or glass. as you see closure materials also, whatever packaging materials we have, same materials, you know, whether plastic, metal, glass gets used for closures. Printing also I wanted to touch, because all materials finally for the aesthetic look, for communicating the product characteristics, regulatory matters, of course printing is necessary. Printing also improves the aesthetic. Basic printing process also we have studied, because we have printing technology as a paper, so letterpress, offset, plexogravure, new innovations,
free version inkjet for
printing,
use.
Of course, because and laser printing, digital printing is now, you know, taking off in a big way. Shorter runs, faster runs, especially where, you know, in Europe, digital printing has taken off in a big way, where, you know, costs were very high related to labor, where plate making and so many things were involved. Coatings, of course, are important. Protective, aesthetic, functional type of coatings are there. Protective coating can be, you know, like a scuff proof varnish. Aesthetic coatings now, you know, UV varnish can be aesthetic, plays an aesthetic also. You have matte finish, you have glossy finish, you have textured finish, you know, in UV. Functional, of course, because if you want some barrier properties, then there are coatings which have barrier properties also. Metallic inks, everyone knows, we see a lot of metallic things now in the marketplace. Some of the other, you know, decorating things like heat transfer labeling, hot stamping, in-mold labeling, IML as it is called, dry offset printing, pad printing, which is very old, and screen printing, just quick snapshot of decorating. Plastic packaging films, when we come, the oldest material was cellulose films. Plastics, we know LD, MD, and, you know, a lot of those polymers which we experience. Vinyls, polyester-based, styrene polymers, barriers, you know, nylon-based materials, polycarbonates. And these are the production methods also, which, you know, I don't want to go into much detail, but each is a subject in itself, as we say. Whether extrusion, orientation, calendaring, solvent casting, blowing, injection molding, of course, we all know. Labels, why I'm saying is, labels just as also plays a very important part in anything which we do. Labeling can be part where it is externally applied. Majority of packaging materials get printed on themselves, but there are specific examples where labels also are used. So plain paper, pressure sensitive, of course, we know.
Created with free version for non-commercial use.
Heat seal, heat transfer labels, shrink films. Now, you know, shrink films also in majority of products, which we'll also see from few examples, a mix of the all these things in the examples which I have taken in my presentation. Printing methods, again, we know, flexo, letterpress, gravure, silk screen, hot foil stamping. Okay, now, you know, after this quick thing, you know, what I thought was, you know, it's almost 20, 25 minutes. So another 10, 15 minutes from the shelf. Now, you know, I could have done much better justice if this lockdown was not there, but I had some earlier pictures with me. What I'm going to do is just take few examples of the products which we experience every day in our life. You know, when we go to marketplace, when we buy these products. So, you know, toothpaste is one very good example. We start our day with toothpaste in the morning and a brush. And as you can see, this is a shelf from, you know, I took these pictures maybe a couple of months back in DMart. So as you can see, you know, different categories of products. So at the top, you have, you know, Colgate Total, which is super premium product. Then you have, you know, Colgate Ved Shakti now occupying major shelf because, you know, of its Ayurvedic concept, and also Patanjali and Baba Ramdev shaking up the entire, you know, sector of FMCG about two, three years back. And then the Colgate dental cream, as, you know, earlier we used to call the white paste. So as you can see, even in the marketplace, as a packaging person, when we work, you know, I always tell people in any organization or in any sector where you work, generally, you know, four categories of products are there in any of the organizations, in the product categories, as I say. One is, you know, super premium products. And, you know, super premium products, we know they are the best of the products in that range. They are high priced products, obviously. They have more active ingredients, they have more benefits, they have more marketing attached to it. They are newer products with technology. So super premium products like Colgate Total is one of the best toothpaste in the world. Then comes, you know, premium products. So super premium, premium, then comes mid price, and then value. So generally in any company, wherever you are going to work in future, any FMCG sector, any pharma sector also, or any of these, you know, you will see always marketing, sales, production, all of the business budgets, the development of a product or packaging development, and the product development also depends on the price point. So where in this price point of super premium, premium, mid price and value, your product is going to be launched or is there, or the, which is decided by, of course, marketing and sales, because they are going to sell the product. And that is what determines the product characteristics and the packaging cost, which you can be affording. So, you know, one good shelf showing you
free version for non-commercial
categories
use.
Here. And these categories can change when market disruption is there. Here is another example. Okay, now, you know, here what I want to say is toothpaste, we every day interact. So you have an outer duplex board carton, which can be, you know, hot foil stamping is there, like in Total Carton. It is a regular duplex board. You can have gray back or white back, depending on the product and the price, what you're trying to sell, or the premium image. Then you will have, you know, outside carton can have foil stamping. It has, of course, UV protection on the top. Earlier, solvent-based or water-based varnishes were used. Now, you know, UV varnish is used. You will have matte and glossy finish type of things in the Colgate logo, or certain logo areas you will have glossy finish. In other areas, you will have matte finish. Inside the toothpaste tube is there, which is a multi-layer laminated tube. It is a six-layer laminated tube for people who know, you know, what SL Propack does.
Created
the lamination,
free version for non-commercial
six-layer
use.
Laminate. So in this one pack, you see, you know, you have a duplex board carton. Second, you have a printing process, which is generally, you know, offset UV nowadays because of its fast process. You have foil stamping. Number three is you have a toothpaste tube, which is an all, you know, which is a multi-layer. It has six layer, it is a six layer laminate. And out of this six layer, one of the layer is aluminium foil for barrier properties, of course, and the rest balance five layers are polymers. Mix of polyethylene, then acid copolymer is there, ethylene acrylic acid for people who want to know. And then cap is there, which is injection molded PP cap. Shoulder in the toothpaste tube is compression molded HDP shoulder. And the body of the laminate is six layer, which I told you, which is a multi-layer tandem extruder lamination process. So in one product, you will see different packaging materials being used, different processes being used, and that is what you have to learn. So when we interact with different products, you know, in our life, what we have learned in theory and what you see in your hand, try to correlate these things, because that is how, you know, more learning will come. Now here is another example, you know, of course, of Pepsi can. Now can, you know, is aluminium monoblock. You open top, is there on second side, always is a monoblock can of Gillette shave foam, and you know, again, it has a dispensing PP on Gillette top, you know, PP spout, which dispenses the shave foam, and then of course the top cap. So here you see aluminium as a material is in Pepsi can also, and in Gillette shave foam also. So again, injection molded cap and injection molded
created
spout.
With free version for non-commercial
food
use.
Product. Why I took this example is, you know, aseptic packaging is, you know, what I call a unique pack in whatever packaging we do, because this is a unique multi-layer pack where one of the most unstable products you can call, because milk, you know, as you see Winking Cow, Britannia, or, you know, Mother Dairy is there, or Slice Juice is there. Now people who know, you know, from the food industry. Okay. So aseptic packaging, again is a very technical field. It is again a six layer laminate, which is a mix of paper, plastic and foil. Now this is one unique example why I wanted to take is without refrigeration, without any external protection to the product, which is milk or juice, you know, this, the packaging protects the product, which is milk and juice, from micro growth for up to 6 or 9 months as the shelf life is. you have to understand that when we talk of aseptic packaging, you know, everyone calls it Tetra Pak, but Tetra Pak is the name of the company. But aseptic packaging is very, very unique application of packaging. It is very high end of application where microbes generation, by the way the packaging is made, by the way the packaging is filled on the machine in aseptic Tetra Pak lines or SIG lines, you know, in this field, is how the product is protected. And you have to understand that these are food products which people ingest, and without refrigeration, facing all the hazards which are there in the environment, protecting it for 6 or 9 months is a very tremendous or a very good job, as you can call from packaging point of view. Because if microbes, when a child drinks the milk or we drink juice, if we ingest a product which has got micro contamination, you know, we will have serious food poisoning issues. So again, aseptic, very important field, very important, unique field in packaging, with lot of, you know, high end machines getting used and processes getting used in its manufacturing. Examples of some cosmetic products here, if you see again shelf, you know, perfumes are there. So outer carton, you can see here, you know, the outer carton has matte finish. Of course, this is UV printed. Another example how, you know, aesthetics can be improved. Same example, different products, you know, Nivea versus Engage. There are metallic carton. Again, you know, on the side of this Engage, you see a glass bottle with a cap which is transparent dispensing. So within the same category, different companies, you know, whether it is Nivea, which is Burdoff, and, you know, Engage, you see how the aesthetics on the shelf is, how you try to differentiate your products. Again, here duplex board carton, probably with a metallic, you know, metallized polyester or metallized
created
BOPP.
With free version for non-commercial
then this
use.
You know, Engage, if you see actual product, this is again embossed. So embossing process after printing is also utilized, metallic cartons. Shrink sleeves. So again, you know, when I started my career, you know, plastics were coming in. Earlier, all these powders used to come in tin plate can, and now every single of these powders are in you know, HDP or PP containers with shrink sleeves. So you don't print the container, you just put the shrink sleeve, so you can, you know, minimize your what you call inventory even in the plant. So example, you know, when you see Nycil or, you know, Pond's talc or any of these talcs, the basic container which is blow molded comes plain. The cap colors can be different, but, you know, blown containers always occupy more space in the factory, in the warehouse. So you just, you know, for different fragrances which you have, rose flavor or anything, you just put the shrink sleeve, put that cap color and you produce. So here again, injection molded. Example of how inventory also can be reduced. Because when tin plate can was being used for all powders, you have to print tin plate. That time shrink sleeves had not started. So, you know, this is another example how inventory reduction in a manufacturing plant can happen because of packaging or using a mix of different packaging and labeling solutions which we have around us. Again, you know, Fair and Lovely. So again, metallic carton, premium, super premium, you know, Fair and Lovely, 100 grams maybe cost 150 rupees. At the same time, on the below shelf, you can see stand-up tubes, stand-up transparent tubes. Now, transparent tubes, again, can be monolayer, multilayer with barrier properties. Flip-top caps, of course, again, you know, in caps and closures, there are different type of dispensing. So these are another example. Another shelf example, again, of different products.
Created
transparent.
Free version
again,
for
transparency
use.
In the tube material can be used differently. So, you know, like Himalaya, if you see here, you can do white, opaque printing, so certain part of the tube can be transparent so that you can see the product, the other part of it can be opaque, and, you know, graphics can be used smartly to attract a customer or the product or the package to look good on the shelf. Again, another UD colon or perfume, how metallics, how the graphics are used smartly to deliver a particular wild image, you know, because this is wild stone. So, you know, graphics versus printing versus packaging material, what is used. Agencies, of course, you know, when you work in big FMCGs, as packaging people with marketing, you will also interact with agencies. Many times, you know, these marketing agencies have a lot of fancy ideas. Marketing also, you know, what they see on computer, they feel, you know, can be generated by the packaging.
Created
but there are constraints
for non-commercial
in it.
But use.
These ideas transforming from the marketing or agency into reality is what the packaging person's job is. Again here, same tubes. Now you see metallic finish, what we saw on the cartons, metallic inks. Instead of using BOPP or metallic films in tubes, you can use metallic inks also. So, you know, metallic inks instead of metallic films is another solution. It can be cost saving in some cases where the applications are depending on, you know, what package you are using. Gillette, again, same thing, metallic carton. Carton inside, of course, is a glass bottle, you know, again, super premium product. Sometimes, you know, super premium, as we call in companies, depending on the company, the marketing, you know, super premium image can be transmitted to the customer or the consumer through different ways, sometimes very simple graphics, but effective graphics can denote and super
created
premium
with
image.
Free version
sometimes,
for non-commercial use.
So in some products, you know, huge amount of metallic inks, lot of graphics is used to denote. So it depends on product category also where we are. Again, shampoo bottles, you can see, you know, earlier 10, 20 years, all shampoo bottles were upright, you know, as we see on the bottom shelf in this picture. Now many, you know, like Garnier or L'Oreal, they came first with upside down, you know, as you see on the top shelf. So you have to store the bottle upside down with the flip top cap on the bottom. So this is how, you know, maybe 15, 20 years back, if somebody would have said, "Arey, shampoo bottle should stand on its head," maybe the same, you know, including a packaging person would have laughed. But these are different concepts which we see in market. You know, still even it is a mix of all these things. So what can denote and what the consumer in market can like and then buy the product is always a challenge for packaging. Again, you know, something super premium, how holographic with metallic holographic can be combined in the outside carton. This is like makeup brushes, which you can see, which the ladies use. This is inside, inside a tin can. This has, you know, expanded polyethylene foam where these brushes are kept. So, you know, this is how costly products, super premium products are presented to the customers. Blister packs, again, very simple. You have lip balms, you know, like L'Oreal. You have these, you have this dental brushes, as they are called, orthodontic between the teeth. So, blister packs are also important part. Of course, you can see the package. You can see the entire, product package inside it. It is not inside a carton, and it gives a bigger display image because you know the lip balm or these products are very
created
small.
With free version
so using
for
the backer
use.
Card and the blister, you know the image, the shelf impression of these products is enhanced. So this is another way of enhancing. Perfume bottles, glass bottle. You can see. Now, you know, with sustainability and people are going back again to brown bag craft, you know, the craft color, brown color of the craft paper to communicate, you know, this is natural. This is more towards sustainability. So sometimes, you know, the world moves around again in a circle. Example, again, on the right hand side, you can see there is this, a flap inside fifth panel, as it is called in a carton. Because carton generally is made of fourth panel. Now this also is a cheater, in a way cheater pack, because you know the bottle size, the width of the bottle and the width of the carton is much bigger. So they have used and they don't want this glass bottle to rattle in transit because it is a glass bottle. So they have used a fifth panel to cushion
free
it
version
and,
for
and also a cheater
use.
Pack. You know, in perfumes, you know, which are very costly, super premium, you want shelf impression to be bigger than actually contents what is packed. Again, hand wash, which has become very important now with COVID, but dispensing mechanisms, as we call transparent bottles, opaque bottles, spouted, dispensing mechanisms. Now you don't, so these are some of these examples. Godrej, you know, Goodnight. Why I've taken this is also a very unique example. You know, when when Godrej launched this product, you know, before this, everyone used to use those mosquito mats. Now we use liquids, liquidizers, you know, in our homes. But this also, if you see the unique, you know, cap, then there is this, I don't get the exact word now, I have forgotten. But there is this dispensing of this, you know, good night happens through this spout. And it heats when we put in the machine, and slow dispensing happen. So even this has unique characteristics.
Free version for non-commercial.
This is heated at a certain temperature in that machine when you put, and you know it should not suck up more product. Otherwise, you know the container can get empty in no time. So you know these are unique characteristics which need to be developed in whatever dispensing mechanisms or packaging. Marico, of course, you know, famous pack of hair oil. Flip top cap dispensing. Many of us, you know, who are, you know, maybe 20 years senior to you, we know when in our childhood how the oil used to be dispensed when our grandmother or our mother used to put oil on our head. And it used to be mess. And, you know, oil bottles are always messy. But, you know, Parachute, market leader in coconut hair oil, you know, how dispensing has changed. Again, shampoo bottle, flip-top caps, again, on the left-hand side, right-hand side, both Nivea and, you know, Patanjali. You see, bi-color injection molding. So, you know, this is how technology has also changed. No one would have thought, you know, 15, 20 years back that in the same, you know, injection mold, you can have two colors, you know, on a flip-top cap, the top flip and the body different colors. So, again, examples of technology progression. Dispensing, again, these are body sticks, how, you know, different caps, different shapes of caps, different sizes of caps are used to attract the consumer. You know, basically dispensing inside both these containers, or, you know, the valve which is used, the valve is same, you know, which dispenses the perfume or the fragrance. But you see how the cap and closure has been modified to communicate the image of premiumness to attract the consumer. You know, very famous example, lipstick, because here, you know, the packaging cost is 95 or 96% of the product. So the lipstick, actually, the product cost is only 5% or less than 5%. And the rest, everything,
bought free version
the
for
top
non-commercial
cap and
use.
All is 95% of the cost. So extreme example where packaging cost is 95% of the selling price of a product. Sachets, I don't have to talk. Sachets is everywhere. But at the same time, you know, sachets has made dispensing easier, made affordability, 1 rupee pack, you know, 5 rupee, 3 rupee packs, which have become very important. But at the same time, you know, all these unit doses or small packs dispensing, which have made products affordable, sachets made, you know, more people can afford and use those products instead of shampoo bottles. But at the same time, there on the other side, on sustainability, there is a huge problem of these small packs getting dispensed, you know, thrown everywhere, as we know, whether it is shampoo sachets, whether it is chocolate wrappers, whether it is gutka packs. So, you know, both sides of the same coin. Can, again, you know, Yardley metal can, tin plate can with a shoulder
created
on
with
it,
free
oval
version
can,
for non-commercial use
with dispensing cap with those holes. Toothpaste, which I have spoken already. So, you know, Dant Kanti, as you can see, is with a stand-up cap. So you can use normal cap inside. Okay, last slide. After these products, you know, one last slide I wanted to put was sustainability. Because we started with packaging and 4 packaging materials. And today the entire world is talking of sustainability. So you have to remember that, you know, as we call in sustainability, cradle to the grave, you know, cradle to the grave story. So cradle is where, you know, we use those 4 packaging materials to design those. And grave is when we use the product and throw away the packaging. So on sustainability, one last slide I wanted to put, we use different materials, different material processes, different cost to those materials. But at the same time, when we use the product and throw away the packaging, again, whatever we have used, the materials which we have used, the process which we have used,
created
the cost
with
which
free
we have
version
incurred
for non-commercial
in
use.
Using those packaging materials and packing those materials, finally in sustainability, all that comes back to you. Because plastics, you know, which are a boon. I, of course, consider it as a boon in packaging. But today in sustainability, because of those, same things today it is causing certain issues on sustainability, because yield versus economics, as I have put, monomer versus multi-layers, separation of polymers, microplastics, if you break them down into pieces, these are causing issues on sustainability side. Just one slide, because you know sustainability is a huge subject in itself. So I think with this I have finished. Last slide, I always put of Indian Institute of Packaging. Of course, I have just put Mumbai, but this is our mother institute, and of course Hyderabad, Calcutta, Delhi, all these places IIP has grown over the years. And all of you are examples of it. So last picture from me is of
Indian
Institute.
Created with free version for non-commercial
use.
So
with that, thanks. I finish.
We have certain questions. Although I'm aware that we won't be able to complete all of this in the restricted timeline that we have. But let's try, and if you can answer most of these questions, otherwise we can email these questions to you and then you can, you know, give us your answer there.
Okay.
So the first question was, can electron beam curable coating replace the outer plastic layers for lamy or coax tube?
Can electron beam curing
coatings replace the outer layers for lamy or coax tubes?
Frankly, I don't have an answer to this. Okay.
Fine, sir.
Yeah, because I don't want. Of course, you know, laminate tubes and in Colgate I have worked, but you know, during those times, some of these technologies were under development. So I'm not very. I don't want to answer something which is half. But you know, I will note this down, and even I will try to find out the right answer to this. Okay.
No issue, sir. Yeah. Sir, another question was, can you put some light on the specifications that needs to be considered while going for new product development for cosmetic tubes? I mean, what are the important specifications that need to be, you know, considered when we are going for any new product development in terms of cosmetic tubes?
See, cosmetic tubes, again, I am saying cosmetics is a huge category in itself. As I was, you know, if you have seen my slide when I had put that, cosmetics starts with something with the product characteristic where only moisture barrier is required. Okay. Example I would like to give is something which is hand wash. Okay. We have tubes, face wash, hand wash. Hand wash, I'm being specific. Face wash, I can take, you know, as a next example. Because hand wash tube can be monolayer or multilayer also, but the basic characteristic in hand wash which is required is moisture barrier properties, because you don't want the inside hand wash to get dried. Okay. Now that may require a monolayer tube also, which is even a you know, extruded tube as it is called. Now second layer, as an example, what I can think was from hand wash, if you go to face wash. Now face wash is something which you will apply on your face, and their fragrance also comes along with it, because when you apply on the face, it is very near to your mouth, nose also. So obviously that fragrance you are going to smell more than in a hand wash, you know. So in that case, it is moisture plus the fragrance. Now all these fragrances, as majority of we know, are and you know, Hari is working in a company which is experts, you know, in fragrances and flavors. So fragrances have their own characteristics. They have their own oleoresins and all. And in these type of products, what is really required barrier properties becomes then important. And the third part of it is whether, like a toothpaste tube example, where you are taking it inside your mouth, you are tasting the product. So it has a mint flavor or something. And you know, in a toothpaste tube, that's why it is a multi-layer plastics combined with metal also, aluminium foil also. Now, of course, aluminium foil, there are replacements. There are all APL, as it is called, all plastic laminate, where EVOH has EVOH, you know, ethyl vinyl alcohol is used to replace aluminium foil. So there is no specific answer. And if you remember the first slide, which I put, the product characteristic, the product active ingredients determines what packaging and how barrier properties you are going to build. So this is my answer.
Thank you so much, sir. Another question is, so can you throw some light on the feasibility of recycling for aseptic packaging?
Okay, aseptic packaging, you know, currently I am working on some projects related in last 1 year. And see, aseptic packaging, again, as I said, and it is a good example also to take versus multi-layer pack, you know, plastics also. Now, aseptic packaging, if you say, you know, all those packs which I showed you, as I said, it is a 6-layer laminate. Quickly to tell you, you know, outer is a poly, then there is foil, then there is EAA, and then there is inner poly, sealant poly. So these are the 6 layers. Out of these 6 layers, you have to understand that 75% to 80% by weight is paperboard. Okay, so 75% to 80% of the aseptic pack, whether it is 200 ml, you know, small dosage pack or 1 liter, you know, family packs as they are called, 75% to 80% is paperboard. And that paper is very high quality, long fiber paperboard. Okay, so in paper, we have studied what long fiber is, stiffness, you know, virgin board quality is high. Balance, you know, by weight, 3% to 4% is aluminium foil. And then balance 17% saliance is of polymers. Now on recycling this answer, whether this is recyclable, the answer is yes. But in, you know, as we talk of recycling, there are many things on technology side on recycling which is involved. Now to quickly tell you, all these aseptic tetra packs, as we call it in our day-to-day life, can be recycled. How they can be recycled? The quick answer is all these paperboard, once it is accumulated, if this packs are sent to a paper mill, example, because you know 80% is paper and it is a high quality paper. Now this packs can be shredded and broken down into pieces. They can go into a digester. That machine has to be there, of course, in a paper plant. And in that digester, it is like a centrifuge where water is put, and this entire thing is rotated at high. So what happens is the paper pulp is separated from the polymer and the metal. And this paper pulp is then again reused. You can use it into converting into tissue papers. You can use it into convert into writing papers, you know, writing books for school children. You can use this paper because this is a long fiber and high quality virgin paper. This can be recycled like a normal paper. Again, the balance aluminium part and the poly part also can be, because poly and aluminium foil, you know, the polymer part, if you burn it into an incinerator, you can recover energy from it. Or if you separate aluminium foil, you know, once the polymer is burnt, the metal remains, and metal aluminium foil is a costly material. So this is how it can be done. I can talk on this subject for half an hour, but yes, it is recyclable. The biggest issues in recycling or sustainability comes is after a consumer throws away a certain package, how do you collect and bring it again to a mill, paper mill or a metal mill, where it is again can be reused? The main supply chain is weak on recycling, which is post consumer use collection point to actually getting recycled. That is the weak chain in the entire world, I am telling you. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Just another question was, can metallized paperboard be used for outer carton instead of using metallic printing?
Yes, of course.
And sir, can you throw some light on metallized paperboards in case, you know, if...
See, metallized paperboard is basically a transfer process. What they do is metallic film, you know, the metal is transferred on the board. So earlier, still many companies use, but there are companies which supply you. You supply them the paper board, they do the metallization and supply you back. So definitely metallized board, environmentally, it is better than a metallic BOPP or metallic polyester film being laminated onto the board. But metallic boards are available. And as an example, you know, I can quote you Colgate toothbrush. You know, we had a super premium toothbrush called, there we use metallic board for printing.
Okay.
And many companies now use. So metallic boards is also always a better option than metallic lamination of metallic film to the board and then printing it. But it depends, you know, on what you really want to do and the availability of metallic board also.
Fine. Thank you, sir. Also, So in case of lamy tubes, multi-layer lamy tubes, is there any technology available in India for separating the layers?
See, on tubes separating the layers, because you know, as I said again, laminate tube, say toothpaste, is a 6-layer. You know, outer poly, which is white poly on which printing is done. Then you know there is EAA foil, EAA, and then inner sealant poly, which is transparent. Now separating these layers, you know, because EAA and poly, if you see foil, so it is basically metal and plastics. So there is technology to separate foil and polymer. Like I gave example of aseptic packaging, right? Which paper, foil, and poly, these three get separated. So in the same way, if toothpaste tube is taken, then the shoulder is HDP again. So you know, which is again a different material. The cap is PP. Of course, cap can be manually removed and used. So you have a mix of, you know, 3-4 polymers per se in a tube, and then a metal in it. So I think the easiest way, where metal plastic combination, is make use of the calorific value of the polymer. You know, when you burn it into an incinerator, all polymers derived from petrochemicals always have a calorific value. So the best way is to recover the calorific value and metal, because once you burn all the polymer, the aluminium foil remains, and foil which gets converted into just aluminium lump, that aluminium again is a pure metal which can be always recycled.
Correct. So sir, the better option here is incineration.
Yeah, this is one of the thing, because you know, when I talk of 4 polymers, separating those polymers again, what are you going to do with it is a question. Because separation processes, if you see, are available, but they are all solvent based, what I know of as of today. But after you separate, use solvents, you know, again, solvents are dangerous to the environment. We all know solvents are not easy to handle in a company. And by using all this technology, when you separate them out, what are you again going to do? The cost which you are going to incur in separating those polymers and doing, then it is better to recover the calorific value of a polymer, and the metal is separated out, and you use that. This is my point of view.
Great, sir. Thank you so much. I think most of the questions are answered here. There would be, I think, a couple of, like, 2 or 3 more questions, but I think I can email them to you. Anybody from the task force can email it to you, and we can get back to the students with a, you know, brief answer to those.
Okay.
Great. Thank you so much.
So can we conclude the session now?
Yes. Ayush?
Yeah. Yes. Okay, Hari and Ayush and Ajay, I just want to say few things, you know, just 1 or 2 lines at the end before, you know.
Please, sir.
I just want to say that everyone, whether it is the 34th batch students or 35th who are still in their second semester, and all of the experienced guy, like, you know, Ayush is there, maybe 6-7 years experience. Hari is there, Hari Narayan Patel, with, you know, 17 or 18-20 years experience. Or me, please understand that the current global situation is very, very unique. Okay, all the people in the world, all the people, not just packaging people, all the people in different professions have different anxiety levels. Okay, they are not sure what is, and no one has an answer today. Okay, we see political part on television, we hear, we read so many things. And this is a really very unique situation which each one of us seen. No one has experienced this ever in their lifetime, not even in our fathers, our grandfathers' generation. What I am telling all of the packaging fraternity, because, and what I feel is, today all of us are locked in our homes, okay? Try to stay happy as much as possible. Don't worry too much about what is going to happen after this situation opens. Because what is going to happen, all of us are going to see. All of us are going to experience that. But please understand, the most important thing in life is life. Okay? Each and every one life. Your own life, your own close family life, your friend's life, your packaging friend's life, everyone's. So please take care of life. Other things come after that. If the बोलते हैं ना जान है तो जहान है. So you know, and everyone has worries. Everyone has worry. मेरे job का क्या होगा? People, companies will reduce. Businessmen are worried. How am I going to pay salaries of people? I don't have business. I am telling you today also. In last 1 week, certain factories have started, and big multinational factories. Huh? And I was talking to very senior people. Cash cycle is severely affected, because even though companies have started in last 1 week, but what are they going to do with the finished product? Because 90% of the retail shops in the country and in the world are closed. So what they are saying is, when it is going to open? After it opens again, we don't know where this virus can take all of us. So cash cycle getting affected severely in the entire world is a fact. What yes, we are doing in our home, in our webinar today, we exchange some information. But my sincere request to all of you is, please don't panic in life. Okay, try to stay as calm as possible. Try to do whatever you are doing in your home. Try to stay happy. You know, webinar is one. We got engaged everyone for 1 hour. So we moved away from what we were doing routinely. You are engaging more with your family in your home also. Your hobbies, as I always tell, try to pursue your hobby. Now, external, out of the home hobbies, you obviously cannot pursue. So and stay calm. Don't try to panic yourself. Don't try to panic your family members. Don't try to worry about things where no one has answers to it. Okay, packaging questions, we can have answers.
Yes, sir.
But what we are experienced today, please believe me, no one in the world has answer, whether it is the President of United States or President or Prime Minister of India or China. So we have to face the situation as the day comes and the day passes, and stay calm, because you know, always when you stay calm, you will always have better situation to face the reality. Even if something crisis happen, a calm mind always takes you forward. A panic mind always leads to disaster. So that is only my last statement to all of you, and thank you very much for everyone.
Yeah. So, Hari sir, would you like to add something?
Yeah.
Concluding vote of thanks on part of all, then we can go.
Yeah. Prabhu sir, behalf of all of us, task force and students, we would like to thank, and we would like to thank Google platform, because there was no quality issue. So really we enjoyed this session, and I would like to thank you, our committee, and most important, the students who have given their time. And I can see around 122-124 kind of numbers were there, but number yes. have gone below 110. So thank you everyone, as we have just completed the time also. It's just 8:03. Okay, so thank you Prabhu sir again. Thank you everyone. It was a wonderful session. Thank you.
Yeah, sir.